My name is Jordan Smelly. I am a certified mental health peer specialist here in Texas. And I also happen to have intellectual and developmental differences. I say intellectual and developmental differences because when we're talking about persons with IDD, one word for disability is disabled, and another synonym for disabled is broken. And persons with IDD are not broken. They just happen to have differences that in certain situations, they need more support. And that's okay. So growing up with, mental health challenges and learning differences was interesting, to say the least. Always struggled in school, but I had amazing parents and support. College was interesting, definitely different experience. It wasn't the greatest experience for me because when I was in college, I still hadn't really learned how to advocate for myself. And so it was kind of hard to get the support that I needed because I didn't necessarily know what to ask for. But as the years have gone by since I, went to college, I've learned more about myself and I've learned how to advocate for myself. Once I got really good at advocating for myself, then I kind of developed a passion to try and help advocate for others, which is kind of why I became a mental health peer specialist. Because one thing as a mental health peer specialist is I help people learn how to advocate for themselves. And I can also do that by role modeling what it looks like. So as a peer support provider, typical days, there really is no such thing as a typical day, really. Unless you're talking about like get up out of bed, eat breakfast, take my meds, brush my teeth, get showered, get dressed, and then go to work, which I actually happen to work from home now for a virtual peer support pilot, and so it's very nice. It's nice being able to work from home and advocate, help show people how to advocate for themselves and meeting them on Zoom, because not everyone with intellectual and developmental differences is able to drive, and so being able to be a part of a virtual peer support pilot gives us the option and the availability to support those with IDD who might have a harder time getting out into the community. When I kind of am supporting people with others with IDD, some of the things that are kind of misunderstood about persons with IDD and mental health challenges is that the greatest barrier persons with disabilities face is not steps or curbs, it's expectations. And that's a quote by Karen Clay. And so it really trying to fit persons with IDD and mental health challenges into a box or one size fits all does not really work. And you can fix that ideology by using a more person-centered and trauma-informed approach. So person-centered means that the person receiving support is in the driver's seat and also has a say in their treatment. One of the cool things that I have gotten to do as far as advocacy is, this past Texas legislative session, I got to help get a bill filed, HB 4702, which would have created the stakeholder group to create a Medicaid billable IDD peer support benefit and certification for persons with IDD living outside of state-supported living centers. And the reason state-supported living centers were carved out is because currently here in Texas, at least, persons with IDD that live inside state-supported living centers have access to peer support in a way that works for that environment. And so if it kind of works for them and they have access, you know, you don't necessarily need to go reinvent the wheel, so to speak. And so I was able to, you know, help get it filed, and we were able to get it through the House. Unfortunately, not in enough time to get it through the Senate, but that's okay, because we will work on getting it refiled next session, which will be in 2025, so next year. And then we think we can get it pushed through next session and get it passed. So for those of you who work with persons with IDD, that are supporting those with IDD that might have a little bit of trouble finding their voice, is it's okay to struggle with finding your voice, because that is something that it takes time to learn how to do effectively and in a way that you do not rub people the wrong way. And you know, I kind of like to, when I'm supporting persons with IDD and helping them learn how to advocate, I like to tell them, when you're advocating, you will be amazed how far you will get and how much support you will get if you remember the three C's, which is stay calm, cool, and collected. Because if you're able to stay calm, cool, and collected, and rationally explain what support you are needing or the problem you are having, you would be amazed how willing people will be to support you or answer your question, versus if you get upset with them and start cursing them out. How can society do better at supporting young people with IDD and mental health challenges? That's a kind of a really easy thing, because the one thing you can do is stop assuming behavior, the intention behind certain behaviors, because for some persons with IDD, there's a delay in social skills development. And so when you're automatically assuming the intent behind their behavior, you're not helping them get the support they are needing. Instead, you should be asking questions and trying to understand why they are doing what they are doing, so that you can provide the support they are looking for or refer them to the appropriate resource. Thanks for listening. Have a great rest of your day.